our final first round match tonight in the WCW Heavyweight Championship Tournament. We know now about the hairline fracture Bret Hart is suffering, but it's clear cut for any competitor in WCW. You've got to do what it takes to win the world title. Any other match, Bret Hart may have said, nah, forget it, I'll let this heal. But this is his chance to become the U.S. champion tonight and to further in the tournament the crown of
the champ. I was in St. Louis one night over 30 years ago. Lou Fez came in with a broken ankle. He taped his leg so tight and then wrestled to an hour draw. There's just some things you have to do when you have to do it. And Bret Hart feels he has to do this. He has to get into the ring. He has to have his shot at Goldberg. Anything could happen. Anything could happen. He could be lucky. That's the only thing that's going to help him out tonight. He's going to have to be lucky. Because he can't fight Goldberg with just one leg. Nobody can. Unless you're maybe a Sid Vicious, but with a hairline fracture, it's just going to get worse. The more he's on it, the worse it's going to get.
You got to cut out the pain if you possibly can, but this is a hairline fracture, and this is a man who fears no man, who is more intense. I'm talking about his opponent, who we're going to see in just a minute, than he's ever been. He completely ran over Sid Vicious last night. A Sid Vicious who kept coming and coming and coming until he could not come anymore.
But the referee stopped the match. It wasn't Sid.
That's right.
He didn't ask to ring the bell. He still wanted him. Even when he was taken up the aisle by Steiner, he wanted to come back in that ring. He wiped that blood off his face. He wanted to keep on going. I've never seen a man fight like that in my life. Believe me, Goldberg may hate him, but he's got new respect for Sid Vicious.
We all do. And to add to that, Goldberg, after that brutality war, answered the call, the challenge from Sting. As you look at the door, is he ready? Here he comes.
The man!
And after that dramatic triple events that happened last night, Sting comes back out. He says, I want a match. Goldberg answered the challenge. One, Sting said it was not for the title. We all thought he had won the title last night. He did win the U.S. title. Sting, as we saw at the top of the program, McCauley attacked the referee, stripped of the world title. The world title being held up. No man has the belt right now. This is the final of the first round matches tonight. The tournament will continue next week on this program. And who in the world knows what to expect next week? I mean, if the outsiders didn't know what to expect, how in the world are we going to know?
And you got
to
say this about Goldberg. Last night, he won the United States Championship. Then in a matter of an hour or so, went out and won the World Championship, he thought. That's hard to do in one night, believe me. Very hard to do. I don't think it's ever been done.
He is from Dawsonville, Georgia. He is the new
ready.
Yeah, he's not concerned about any injuries. As a matter of fact, with all the rage that he has, I wonder what's going through his mind right now.
You know, he's played hurt, too. He understands what Bret Hart's going through, but business is business, pal.
No kidding. And it's Goldberg's business. And when he steps in the ring, he's...
all business.
Yeah, he's the CEO.
The man...
We can't wait. Here we go. United States title is on the line, as we said. As you know, he'll put it up. But
you just know what's going through Bret Hart's mind. How can I keep him away from this leg? How long will this leg last? Can I go 20 minutes? Can I go a half hour? How much time do I have? I've got to keep him away from this leg.
Goldberg actually looking at him, saying, hey, what about your leg? Hairline fracture of the shin, of the ankle, of that bone, was the diagnosis. And it all started with the bat from the Total Package last Monday. further aggravated, as we saw earlier, when he fell out of the ring last night. And they hook up. I think the strategy for Goldberg here is clear-cut, Frank.
You know, and that bat belongs to Sting.
Where does it ever? Who also advanced in the tournament tonight. Winner becomes a U.S. champ, and the winner advances on in the tournament.
See, this is very hard. Brett's thinking how to keep him away from the leg, but he's also got to think, what can I do to beat this man? You're not going to win this match by just staying with him.
Goldberg tried to send him into the ropes, and Bret Hart didn't need to go there. He held his own, and what does Goldberg do? He just levels Bret Hart. Way up! Goldberg press slam! In!
Wow.
To a hard put down in the center of the ring.
Goldberg's got to do what he has to do, though. Bret Hart wouldn't respect him if he didn't.
You know, the pain of this leg, Bret Hart has, and he hasn't really worked on the leg at all, but Bret Hart is, it's just fighting to even get back to his feet, and that's what he's doing. Bret Hart is fighting with everything he got. And Goldberg, rapid fire fist to the gut.
He's just in too much pain to compete.
Here he goes. Oh, that's it.
Why would he do that? Why grab for the ropes? Give it up.
Why would he? If he's going to walk to the ring, limp to the ring, you know he's going to grab for the ropes.
Yeah, but
Bray,
as soon as
this is the World Heavyweight Championship.
I know, but when a man like Goldberg grabs that leg with a hairline fracture, there'll be other days. But maybe.
Maybe there's the key, and maybe there won't. This is the top prize in WCW.
Is it worth all that pain, though?
Yes, it is.
It must be to some people.
Yes, it is.
Wouldn't be to me.
That's why they're there, and you're here.
That's why I never had the World Championship.
Yeah, many other reasons. Bret Hart told Goldberg, he said, come get me. He's got Goldberg, and Bret Hart trying to take the offense to Goldberg. He's got to fight through the pain of the ankle and try to knock the man who just won't go down off his feet.
Well, if he can get his adrenaline going, he can get himself a good streak here and get Goldberg a little rocky, he won't maybe feel that pain in that leg. Maybe that's what he needs to get himself going. Goldberg's just a monster.
Mickey J said, you want to give it up? I'll ring the bell right now. Bret Hart did not even answer. He just rolled over, trying to get to his feet. Goldberg to the leg again. Here we go. Oh! Remember, that's a hairline fracture. But he pops up. This is courage beyond belief.
Well, it's better to get up and try to protect that leg than lay there on the mat. Not much you can do on your back.
In the midsection. Into the corner. To the leg. Asking, Goldberg says. He wants it over right now. And Bret Hart right now gave an answer. He said no that time. Last time, no answer.
Well, Mickey J, a veteran referee, he was the one that stopped the match last night with Sid Vicious and Goldberg. Maybe his heart will be big enough to stop it now, so this man, Bret Hart, isn't crippled for life.
As of the epitome of what? A WCW wrestler is about. We talk so much about how important being the world champion is. I don't think we need to say much more. You're seeing what it's all about in the ring. Goldberg again.
Look at Bret trying to fight to get out of that.
Leg submission hold. Again, Mickey J right on top of it. Mickey J realized how critical this is to his career and how important this match is.
He can't take much more.
Let's listen to this.
Goldberg let go.
Goldberg said he's got to stop. And he said, I ain't stopping nothing, is what Bret Hart said. So now Goldberg takes a different approach. What about this, Frank? It's almost as if he stopped focusing on the leg because Bret Hart wouldn't give up, and now he's just going to try to pound his way to victory here.
I think he realizes now he's just got to get this over with.
Yeah.
That's a humane thing to do. You know what they do with horses.
Yeah, but we've seen there's not much humane in Goldberg, at least over the past week. He can't even stand up, and Goldberg says, checking the thing. to be over.
Well, that's what they always talk about, that courage of the Hart family.
As long as he can stand, he got the right leg up, and it got him going. Here comes Bret Hart. He's on top of Goldberg. He's got a sleeper on Goldberg. He's got a sleeper on Goldberg. And Goldberg just shrugs it off. No, he doesn't. Bret Hart comes back again. And the referee on the Snapmare Takeover gets hit. And Mickey James down.
That was an accident.
Yeah, of course it was. He was trying to get Bret Hart off. Goldberg sends Bret. Oh, he hit his leg again. He hit that same move last night.
Oh, and the Outsiders.
The Outsiders. And Mike, it's Sid Vicious. What's he doing here? I didn't know Sid Vicious was here. But he's in the Outsiders. Sid Vicious. Remember the interview from last night after the match?
It's not over yet, he said.
Look at his head. The injury from last night. He said, I will have my day with Goldberg. This must be it. All three attacking Goldberg. Bret Hart is down on the floor. He's not even aware this is going on.
It's 3-on-1.
Now Sid.
He's going to powerbomb him, I bet, Tony.
Is Goldberg out? That's what he's going to do. That's what I'll do. He powerbombed Goldberg. And again, I look to my right. There you see, in the right of your screen, down is Bret Hart. He is not even aware of what's happened. And they've all gone.
Well, Goldberg just took a beating from the Outsiders, Hall and Nash, and a big, big beating from Sid Vicious. And like you say, Bret Hart isn't even aware of what's happening here.
Powerbombed, repeatedly attacked in the powerbomb of the end, and Goldberg. Goldberg cannot even get to his feet. Hart rolling in. Mickey J is up. Bret Hart once again did not even know this went down.
Mickey J don't even know what happened.
No, he doesn't.
He did the unbelievable.
Bret Hart has won it. He is advanced.
Goldberg's out.
It is an extraordinary.
And Bret Hart is the new U.S. champion.
You've just entered the